Hello friends, good morning. In my previous video lecture, I have explained you the details of resistance switching. In this video lecture, I will explain you the duties of circuit breaker, ratings of circuit breakers and capacities of circuit breakers. So let us start with the duties of circuit breaker. So I will explain these duties and corresponding capacities with reference to this diagram. This is single line diagram of power system. The generator, two line section AB, BC. Circuit breaker A is operating for the faults in section AB. Circuit breaker B is operating for the faults in section BC. I have shown fault F1 in section AB and fault F2 in section BC. First duty of the circuit breaker is, it must be capable of operating on occurrence of the fault. It must be capable of operating on occurrence of the fault. And corresponding capacity is called as breaking capacity of the circuit breaker. So when fault takes place in this section, say F1, A must be capable of operating, that is interrupting the fault current. When fault takes place here, that is F2, circuit breaker B must be capable of operating, that is interrupting the fault current. That is called as, corresponding to that, we call this as breaking capacity. Second duty. It must be capable of remaining closed on occurrence of the fault. Remaining closed on occurrence of the fault means, the sequence of operation is, fault takes place, then relay detects the fault, relay closes its contact, trip circuit is energized, and after that circuit breaker starts operating. So in the meantime, the current is flowing through the circuit breaker. So it must be capable of carrying that current during, before the circuit breaker starts operating. So corresponding to this capacity is called as making capacity of the circuit breaker. So when fault F1 takes place, so before opening of this circuit breaker, it must be capable of carrying the fault current. For fault F2, before operating, circuit breaker B must be capable of carrying this fault current without any damage. So corresponding capacity is called as making capacity of the circuit breaker. Third is fault time rating. Third duty of the circuit breaker, it must be capable of carrying the fault current without any damage to its fault when its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault. And corresponding capacity is called as short time rating. So when fault takes place at this section, that is fault F2, current is flowing through A, circuit breaker A also. So its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault. So this circuit breaker must be capable of carrying the fault current when its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault. So this is corresponding to this, the capacity is called as short time rating of the circuit breaker. So three capacities are there: breaking capacity, making capacity and short time rating. Now I will discuss all these capacities in detail. Now let us see what are the capacities of circuit breaker. First is breaking capacity. Definition: it is a term used to express the current which the circuit breaker is capable of interrupting at the stated recovery voltage and the stated reference restriking voltage under prescribed condition of use and behavior. I repeat, it is a term used to express the current the circuit breaker is capable of interrupting at the stated recovery voltage and the stated reference restriking voltage under prescribed condition of use and behavior. If this current is symmetrical, it is called as symmetrical breaking capacity. If this current is asymmetrical, then it is called as asymmetrical breaking capacity. Now let us see what is the difference between these two currents. You are familiar with the short circuit oscillogram of fault current. When short circuit takes place, there is possibility of having DC offset of the fault current. So here I have shown sinusoidal component, that is AC component of the fault current, and this is exponentially decaying component, that is DC offset current, DC offset of the fault current. Now at the instant of contact separation, let us say this is the instant of contact separation. So in this diagram I have shown these two components separately. In this I have shown the resultant component, means AC plus DC offset. Let us say M is the instant of contact separation. Now, The context separation can be anything between 0 to 360 degree on the current wave. But the worst condition is when current is passing through positive peak or negative peak. So here I am considering the worst condition and I assume that current is passing through its positive peak. So it is the current which circuit breaker is interrupting, and this is the current at the instant of context separation. So here if we observe, this is the peak value of the AC component only. So a symmetrical current will be x, that is peak value divided by root 2, that is the RMS value. Now if we add these two and take the RMS value, we get a symmetrical current is equal to square root of this peak value divided by root 2 plus y. Now here this is x, that is AC component, and at the instant of context separation this is y. So it is x by root 2 square plus y square and complete square root. So symmetrical current is defined as the RMS value of the current, RMS value of the AC component of the current at the instant of context separation. So it is the RMS value of AC component of current at the instant of context separation. And asymmetrical current is defined as the RMS value of total current including AC plus DC offset at the instant of context separation. So it is asymmetrical current, AC plus DC its RMS value. And when we take this ratio y upon x into 100, this shows percentage DC component at the instant of context separation. So that is asymmetrical current and asymmetrical current. Now let us see how the breaking capacity is defined. It is breaking capacity. It is the product of breaking current, rated voltage, and a factor used to define the circuit type. If it is single phase circuit, it is 1. If it is 3 phase circuit, it is root 3. So current will be expressed in kiloamperes, voltage will be expressed in kV. Therefore, the breaking capacity will be expressed in MVA, megavolt ampere. So here it is the formula. I have shown this for the 3 phase circuit. So breaking capacity is equal to root 3 times symmetrical current multiplied by rated voltage. It is in kiloampere and it is in kilovolts. So if we are taking here symmetrical current, it is called as symmetrical breaking capacity. If you are taking this as asymmetrical current, then it will be asymmetrical breaking capacity. So this is how we define the breaking capacity, symmetrical as well as asymmetrical. Next is making capacity. Now I will define the making capacity. First I will define making current. It is the RMS value of total current including AC component and DC component measured from the first peak of the short circuit analog of the fault current before opening of the circuit breaker contact. So here it is short circuit oscillogram of the current. This is the resultant. So making current is the RMS value of total current. So here it is AC component peak value. If I here denoted this by P, so P upon root 2 complete square plus DC component, that is Q, so plus Q square and complete square root. So it is the total RMS value of total current consisting of AC component and DC component measured from first peak of the short circuit oscillogram of the fault current before opening of the circuit breaker. So this is the making current. So making capacity corresponds to this making current at the rated voltage, and it represents the capacity of the circuit breaker to withstand the electromagnetic stresses. See, before context separation, circuit breaker has to carry this high current. So this current is very very high because in the beginning DC offset of the fault current is very high. So circuit breaker has to sustain the electromagnetic stresses developed due to this high current. So that capacity is called as making capacity. Making means to remain closed on occurrence of the fault when it has to operate on the fault. And making capacity in mathematically is given by this formula, 2.55 times breaking symmetrical capacity. So making capacity is 2.55 times symmetrical breaking capacity of the circuit breaker. So that is about the making capacity. Third capacity is clock time rating. It is defined as the ability of the circuit breaker to remain inoperative when its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault. So it is the ability of the circuit breaker to remain closed when its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault. So when its nearby circuit breaker is clearing the fault, whatever fault current is there, that is flowing through this circuit breaker. So thermal and mechanical stresses will be developed on this circuit breaker. So its ability to sustain those thermal and mechanical stresses gives the short time rating of the circuit breaker. Now if symmetrical ratio of the symmetrical current and rated current is less than or equal to 40, then short time rating is 3 seconds, and if it is greater than 40, short time rating is 1 second. So these are three capacities: braking capacity, making capacity and short time rating. These are also ratings of the circuit breaker. So now I will explain the remaining ratings, but these ratings will include braking capacity, making capacity and short time rating. Now I will explain the remaining ratings of the circuit breaker. Now the remaining ratings. First three are braking capacity, making capacity. Third is short time rating. Fourth is rated voltage. But there are two voltage ratings. One is nominal voltage. Second is maximum operating voltage. Nominal voltage means whatever is the system voltage, that is the nominal voltage of the circuit breaker. For example, if it is 220 kV system, then circuit breaker rated voltage, nominal voltage will be 220 kV. 400 kV will be 400 kV. Maximum operating voltage, it is the voltage for which the insulation is designed. Means the in any case, this value should not, the voltage appearing across the breaker in normal condition should not exceed this voltage. So I already explained you that maximum operating voltage is 1.1 times the nominal system voltage if system voltage is up to 220 kV. If system voltage is higher than 220 kV, then maximum operating voltage is 1.05 times system voltage. So for 220 kV, it will be 1.1 into 220, that is 242 kV. For 400 kV system, it is 1.05 into 400, that is 420 kV. Next is rated current. Definition: it is the current the circuit breaker must be capable of carrying continuously with temperature rise of its different parts not exceeding the prescribed value. So in normal condition, circuit breaker has to carry full load current. So when full load current is flowing, there will be heating, temperature will increase. So under test condition, this current is passed for certain time, and during this time the temperature of all its components should not exceed the specified limit. So that is the rated current. Rated frequency is the frequency of the system. In India it is 50 Hertz. Next is operating duty. Operating duty is defined as number of prescribed operation at the stated time interval. Prescribed operation means circuit breaker has to perform opening closing operations. So in the stated time interval, whether circuit breaker is capable of performing all these specified operations safely or without any difficulty is checked in this. So that is the operating duty. And last is rated interrupting time. It is the mean time of interrupting any current which is less than rated interrupting current of the circuit breaker. So that is interrupting time. So I have defined you the duties, capacities and finally the ratings of the circuit breaker. Ratings are braking capacity, making capacity, short time rating, rated voltage, rated current, rated frequency, operating duty and rated interrupting time. Now I will explain you the different time components on after occurrence of the fault up to the fault clearance. Now I will explain the time components from fault occurrence up to circuit breaker reclosing. I already explained the relays as well as circuit breaker. So here in this timeline, A is instant of fault occurrence. Fault occurs, parameters change, so relay detects the fault. Then at B, it is the instant of closing of relay contact. Relay detects the fault and it closes its contact. So when relay closes its contact, circuit breaker trip coil will be energized and circuit breaker contact will start moving apart. So from CB to C, it is circuit breaker operating time. That is, at instant C, the opening of arcing contact. Means contact will start opening and finally they will come to their last position. So this is the instant when circuit breaker has fully operated. So this is circuit breaker operating time. Now when circuit breaker has fully operated, there is still arc because it is changeover from current carrying to voltage with standing state. So arc is there between the contacts. Then arc will persist for some time. So at instant D, arc will be interrupted. So from C to D, it is arcing time. So if we consider from B to C, it is circuit breaker interrupting time. From C to B to D, it is circuit breaker interrupting time because here circuit breaker has started operating and here the arc is fully extinguished. So circuit is open. So therefore it is interrupting time of the circuit breaker. Now in modern system, auto reclosing is provided. So after some time, circuit breaker contacts will again close. So from start of opening of the contact up to reclosing of the contact, it is circuit breaker reclosing time. Now here fault has taken place, relay detects the fault, relay closes the contact, circuit breaker contact start opening and at D final arc extinction takes place. So when a final arc extinction has taken place, then we say that fault is cleared. So here fault has occurred and here it is finally cleared. So this TCL is the fault clearing time. So these are various components of the time from occurrence of the fault up to the circuit breaker reclosing. So in this video lecture, I have explained duties of the circuit breaker, capacities of the circuit breaker, ratings of the circuit breaker and different time components from occurrence of the fault up to reclosing of the circuit breaker. So friends, if you feel this video lecture useful, then please like it, subscribe to my channel, ask your friends, colleagues and juniors to subscribe to my channel for video lectures on power system protection and high voltage engineering. If you want to make effective and efficient use of time, then read my book on time management. The link for the book is given in the description box. I have learned a useful course for the students on Udemy. This course is very useful for the students who are preparing for entrance and competitive exams. The link for the course is also given in the description box. Thank you.